Streams can be used to efficiently send a large file or payload as an HTTP response. Buffering a large file into your server's memory before sending it as a response is an inefficient use of time and resources. Instead, we can pipe a stream directly to a response object. In this tutorial, we'll discuss streaming data to a response body, we'll pipe the content of a file from the file system directly to an HTTP response, and we'll show how to implement file downloads when working with Express. Internally, Express is using Node.js's built-in HTTP capabilities. Express's response object extends Node.js's built-in HTTP server response class, and the server response class implements a writable stream interface, which means that Express's response object also implements a writable stream interface. This allows us to pipe data directly to the underlying response object. To get started, clone the starter repo for this tutorial and open it in your editor. You can find a link to the repository in the written component of this tutorial. The repo has a very basic Express server and also a data directory with a CSV file inside of it. Make sure to install all the dependencies by running npm I in your terminal. We'll need the fs module to create a readstream from the CSV file, so we require fs at the top of our file. Next, we'll create a slash download route, which will send the file's contents as its response. After creating the route, we need to create a readstream from the file. We pass fs.createReadStream, the path to our CSV file in the data directory. CreateReadStream will return a stream representing the file's contents. Once we've created the readstream, we can pipe the file's content directly to the response object. Save the file and start the server with node index.js in your terminal. Then open a browser window to localhost 3000/download. You should see the CSV data load onto the page. You can stop the server back in your terminal with Control C. This simple approach sends the file contents as a string directly to the browser. But we're not quite done yet. We aren't handling things that can go wrong, and our file wasn't actually downloaded. It was just displayed on the page. Next, let's handle the case where the file doesn't exist or it can't be opened by the server. The readstream that fs.createReadStream returns has a special event called open that fires when the file has been successfully opened. This event tells us that the file can actually be read, and we should wait for this event to fire before piping from the stream. The file stream itself can also emit an error event. If something goes wrong reading the file, like if the file doesn't exist, or you don't have permission to read it, or anything else that goes wrong. If you don't handle this error event, it can actually crash your server. Let's see what happens if we try to read a file that doesn't actually exist. If you look at the terminal window, you'll see a no such file or directory error, and you'll also notice that the server isn't running anymore. It crashed when we tried to read a non-existing file. To avoid this fatal crash, we'll add an event listener for the error event onto the file stream. In the event handler, we can call next with the error in order to pass the error onto an error handling middleware. Let's save the file, start the server again, and try to reload that page again in our browser. This time, we get a message from Express's default error handling middleware. And back in the terminal, notice that the server's still running. It didn't crash this time because we were actually handling the error that was emitted. In this example, we're manually handling errors and listening to events on the stream, instead of using the pipeline method that is also available from the stream module. In most cases, using pipeline is recommended over using pipe and manually listening to stream events. But for this particular use case, doing it manually is important. That's because the pipeline method will destroy the streams passed to it when an error event is emitted. That means that if we used pipeline and an error event was emitted, our response object will have its writable stream destroyed, and we won't be able to send back a response using it. Before we forget, let's make sure to switch this back to a file that actually exists. And we'll stop the server with Control-C again. Currently, our browser is displaying the file's content inline on the page, meaning it loads the content directly in the browser as if it was a web page. That's because we haven't set any headers on the response to tell the browser about the content it's receiving. To get the browser to treat the file as a download and actually download it to your computer, there's a few headers that we need to set. To get the browser to download the file, we would need to set at least a content type header on the response to specify the type of file we're sending. We can also set a content disposition header set to the value attachment with an optional file name to tell the browser we're sending a file as an attachment on the response. Express has a useful response method called rest.attachment, which will set both of these headers for us. We can pass rest.attachment a name for the file, and it will guess the content type from the file's extension, as well as set the name the file will be downloaded under. If we save this file and start the server again, and open our browser back to localhost 3000 download, you can see at the bottom of the page that the browser downloaded the file using the name that we specified. To recap, in this tutorial, we discussed how Express allows us to stream to a response because its response object extends Node's built-in server response class, which exposes a writable stream interface. We created a read stream from a file on disk and piped it to the response. We attached listeners to the open and error events on the file stream to make sure we handle any errors that are encountered when creating a stream from the file. To make our browser download the file, we use the express rest.attachment method to add content type and content disposition headers to the response.